डियर स्टूडेंट्स नमस्कार, माई सेल्फ एस के राजपूत एंड टूडे वी विल लर्न टाइप्स ऑफ बॉन्ड्स इन केमिस्ट्री। सो इन डिफरेंट कंपाउंड डिफरेंट मालिक्यूल्स द नेचर ऑफ बॉन्ड इज क्लासिफाइड इन थ्री डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ बॉन्ड अदरवाइज शेयरिंग ऑफ बॉन्ड्स sharing of electrons. So on this basis of mode of sharing of electrons, bonds are three types. First is ionic bond, second is covalent bond, and third one is coordinate bond. Coordinate otherwise coordination, covalent bond and ionic bond. Ionic bond, in ionic bond there are word ions. When suppose this is metal, this is non-metal, by transferring of electrons from metal to non-metal the bond form which provide ions. Valence electron of metals goes and these electrons are taken by this negative species. This is called non-metal, this is alkali metal. Metal become negative by gaining of electron and metal become positive by donating of electron. Suppose simple example, suppose Na NaCl, these two are reacting. The atomic number of Na is 11, sodium. 11 means 2, 8, 1. This is electronic configuration. In first cell, second cell, last cell. The last cell is called valence cell. In valence cell, there is only one electron. This one electron is transferred from sodium to chlorine. Atomic number of chlorine is 17. 17 means 2, 8, 7. In last cell, there is 7 electron. So, to obtain 8 electron in last cell is valence cell. And 8 electrons means octet. Octet means set of 8 electrons. So, to obtain 8 electrons, element exchange their electrons. Here, to obtain stable configuration, 2-8. Sodium can transfer 1 electron and chlorine can take 1 electron to become 8. After the reaction, listen. This is sodium system. Sodium have 3 cells. This is chlorine. Chlorine also have 3 cells. But in sodium, first cell 2, second cell 8, in last cell there is only 1 electron. But in chlorine there are 2, there are 8, and in last cell there are 7 electron. So if sodium, this is metal, it donate means transfer 1 electron and completely give 1 electron to chlorine. After the reaction, sodium Na will become this type. In first cell there are 2, in last cell there are 8 electron. So it become 2-8 and it has transferred 1 electron, completely donated 1 electron. So there will be 1 positive charge on sodium. We can write this type Na plus. Plus means cation. The cation means it has given 1 electron to another element. This chlorine is non-metal, it is taking 1 electron from sodium. So chlorine become this type, first, second and third, 2, 8, in last cell 8, from where 8, 7 and 1 transfer from sodium. So first chlorine we can write 2, 8, 8. Now in this condition, in sodium there are 8 electrons, in last cell it has become stable and including chlorine also 8 electrons, it also stable. So chlorine become minus 1, why minus 1? Because it have taken 1 electron given by sodium. So after the reaction, sodium will become, chlorine will become minus, this will become positive, and the bond between these two is called ionic bond, because the negative ion is called anion. So in formation of ionic bond, metal provides its valence electron 1 or 2 to non-metal. Non-metal takes electron and By transferring electron from metal to non-metal, after transferring, metal become plus positive charge, called cation, and non-metal become negative charge, called anion. And the bond between these two metal and non-metal is called ionic bond. This is NaCl, sodium chloride. So, if we want to learn different types, properties of ionic bond. I am writing a trick, that is, topic is properties of ionic compound, means the compound in which ionic bond is formed. Property we can remember by sivum. Now listen, what is the meaning of sivum? S stands for solubility. H stands for hardness. I stands for current. This I means current, otherwise conductivity. V means valence electron. This A means attraction. And M stands for melting point. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 basic properties of ionic compound. First is solubility. Suppose this is ionic compound. If we dissolve this ionic compound in water, so it provides ions plus and minus. Here we write AQ. AQ means aqueous. Cation and anions are dissolved in water and form their aqueous solution. So remember, ionic compound are soluble in aqueous, in water. And ionic compound are insoluble in organic compound, otherwise in those liquid which are non-polar. So this solution provide ions. In solid state, ions are present, but these ions are strongly connected by a bond, ionic bond, electrostatic bond. So in solid state, ions are not free to move here and there. But when we dissolve this compound in water, otherwise when we provide heat, so on a strong heat, these ions become separate. So if ions become separate by heating, otherwise dissolving water, these ions are responsible for current. So remember, in case of this point, third point, I means current, means conductivity, ionic compound are non-conductor in solid state due to strong bonding between cation and anion, but these ionic compound are good conductor in their molten state by heating, otherwise in their solution state if we dissolve in any polar solution, just like water. Second, H, hardness. Ionic compound are very hard. They exist in a solid state and they are hard and form crystalline solid. I, current, we have discussed valence electron. In formation of valence electron, in formation of ionic compound, the valence electron exchange. Valence electron of cation remove and goes to inside valence electron of anion. Attraction. In ionic compound, there is attraction between these two. This is cation, this is anion. This is attraction, and this attraction is called electrovalent bond. Electrovalent bond means the bond is formed between these two charged particles. And last, melting and boiling point. The melting and boiling point of these ionic compound are very, very, very high. In case of NaCl, the melting point of NaCl is 788 degrees Celsius positive. On this temperature, otherwise above this temperature, NaCl melt, then it show conductivity. Suppose here we can observe this type. In this case, this is metal, this is non-metal. Metal is providing electron 1 or 2 according to number of valence electrons in here. It provides electrons, and electrons goes from metal to non-metal. Non-metal become minus. Suppose this is X may be chloride, bromide, something like, and metal may be calcium, magnesium, otherwise sodium. So this is positive, this is negative. Suppose we want to form magnesium chloride. In case of magnesium chloride, we write AmgCl2. In MgCl2, magnesium atomic number of magnesium is here, right? Atomic number of magnesium is 12 means 282. In last cell 282. In last cell there are two electrons. These two electrons are valence electron. So in property we have discussed valence electron of metal transfer to non-metal. Suppose these are chlorine. Chlorine have 17. So 17 means 287. Also here 287. In these two chlorine there is deficiency of electron. One electron from magnesium obtained to this chlorine, and another chlorine also takes one electron from here. So this means one electron transfer here to here, it become 288, and one electron transfer of magnesium to this chlorine, it will also become 288, and magnesium after the reaction, what will magnesium? Magnesium will become 2N8 due to plus 2. Plus 2 means 2 electron of magnesium completely transferred from here, from magnesium to where? To chlorine. Chlorine become minus and it become 288. This minus means chlorine have taken one electron, and this is also chlorine minus 288. This, in short, we can write this is MgCl2, magnesium chloride. Very simple. So second is covalent compound, otherwise covalent bond. Covalent, co means equal, and valent means valency. If two element share their valence electron. Now the case is sharing, not transferring. Sharing. Suppose these are two element, it is sharing one electron, it is sharing one electron. So by sharing one electron become two, and they will bond single bond. This single bond represent that this is covalent bond. Between these two element, electron are here. On these two electron, there is charge of both particle with equal charge and equal participation. Suppose very simple example. Suppose hydrogen atomic number one, electron one. This is another hydrogen, atomic number electron. It is, and this is, both are sharing one electron. After the reaction, this hydrogen share electron. Suppose this is hydrogen, and both are hydrogen are sharing electron. So electron become two, and this type bond is formed. We can write here. So on the, this is called bonded pair, BP bonded pair. Bonded pair means the pair of electron which is used in the formation of bond. So this bond is called covalent bond. Covalent means there is a sharing of one electron. The number of electron are equal, one. Suppose oxygen, this is oxygen, this is also oxygen. Due to number of valence electron in oxygen, atomic number of oxygen is 8. So for 8 we can write 2N6. This is 6 means there are 6 electron in outermost shell. So for oxygen we can represent this is oxygen atom, this is another oxygen atom. For first oxygen atom we are writing in the form of dot, valence electron VE, valence electron 6. This oxygen also has valence electron 6. I am representing valence electron of this oxygen in the form of cross. So there are 6, they are 6. They are valence electron in present in the last cell, outermost cell. So to obtain 8 electron in last most cell, 8 electron means octet. Every element want to complete its valency by sharing, otherwise transferring electron. There should be 8 electron. So there is deficiency of 2 electron. In this case also deficiency of 2 electron. So 2 electrons shared by this and 2 electrons shared by this. After this type system will form oxygen and oxygen. 2 electrons are provided by this first atom, its remaining electron these, and 2 electrons provided by this atom, its electron total 6, 4 here and 2 here. So after the reaction this type system will form on their 2 electron, on their 2 electron. So these 2 electron, there are total 4 electron which are shared, 2 by 8 and 2 by 8. So BP means bonded electron, bonded pair are two are pair, one and two, and remaining electron, the valence electron which do not take part in formation of bond are called NP. N means non-bonded, P means pair, the non-bonded, these non-bonded also called lone pair. So represent by NP, other by LP. LP means lone pair, NP means non-bonded pair. So how many non-bonded pair? Here, this is the pair, this pair which do not take part in chemical reaction, this also pair, this pair and this pair, they are 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 are pair of electrons which do not take part in formation of bond. So these are called non-bonded pair, but these are bonded pair. So by help of model we can represent this is simple hydrogen molecule. Hydrogen atom, both are sharing one electron, there is single bond is formed by sharing of electron. But this is oxygen atom. In oxygen atom, can you observe? In this oxygen atom, there was total electron 6. 2 are using in formation of bond. Remaining 2 pair means total 4 electron. And also in case of here, so double bond is formed due to sharing of 2 electron by 8 and sharing of 2 electron by 8. If you can observe this compound, can you guess this compound? This compound is CnHHS, CH4. This shape is called tetrahedral shape. In tetrahedral shape, 4 bonds are oriented in different directions. This is carbon, atomic number of carbon. What is the atomic number of carbon? The atomic number of carbon is 6. So 6, we can write 2, 4. 4 means there are 4 electrons in outermost shell of carbon. So carbon will form 4 bonds. This type, this is carbon, it is sharing 4 electrons with hydrogen. So these dot 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 are electrons of carbon. And I am representing the X, this X is represented of electron of hydrogen. So this type bond will form and this shape is called tetrahedral shape. Tetrahedral shape means this type. Here 2 bonds are aging, one given by hydrogen, one given by carbon. This is a tetrahedral shape. This bond is covalent bond. In case of nitrogen, there will be sharing of 3-3 electron and bond will form triple bond. Listen. Okay. The last is coordinate bond. Coordinate bond. Third one is coordinate bond. Coordinate bond means, suppose this is M for molecule, and in this molecule there are some NP. NP means non-bonded pair. Non, just like in oxygen, these are non-bonded pair. 4. So if any molecule completely donate, means donation, completely donate its non-bonded pair to another atom or another molecule, this may be atom or molecule, non-bonded pair are completely donated. Suppose this is molecule, these are its non-bonded pair, and this molecule is providing its non-bonded pair to another molecular atom. The bond between these two is called coordinate bond. Suppose, listen, this is O2 molecule. O2 means oxygen molecule. This atom have 2 lone pair. This atom also have 2 lone pair, just like this. And this one is, this is O2 molecule, and this O is atom. So atom this type, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is atom. This O2 molecule is providing its non-bonded pair to this atom in this type. Here this is double bond, non-bonded pair, X and X. Suppose these are provided, this enter. Okay. So And this meaning, the meaning of this bond is two electron which are in the form of non-bonded pair. This non-bonded pair is provided by this O2 molecule to this atom. This is oxygen atom. These red color are valence electron of this atom, and these electron, the cross electron, are from this molecule. This bond is called coordinate bond. Otherwise, we can also say coordinate bond is dating bond. Dating bond means transferring of non-bonded pair from one molecule to another atom or another molecule. This whole system is called O3. O3 is the ozone. So, by help of this, we can easily understand how ozone is formed. Ozone is formed by transferring non-bonded pair from O2 molecule to O atom. There is one molecule in which all these type bonds are present. You know, within a single molecule, three type bonds. Which type bond? Ionic bond, covalent bond, and coordinate bond. What is the molecule? Molecule is this. Molecule is simple. What? Molecule is NH4Cl. This is ammonium chloride. Look here. This is nitrogen. In nitrogen, there are three hydrogen, and these hydrogen form by sharing of electron between these two. So in this compound, there is covalent bond. Covalent bond 3. And nitrogen have atomic number 7, so we write 2, 5. 5 means there were 5 electrons in nitrogen as a valence electron. It's 3 electrons, cross, cross, cross. These 3 electrons are used, and remaining 2 electrons are present on nitrogen in the form of non-bonded pair. Out of these 5, 3 are used and remaining are 2. So these are called non-bonded pair. Non-bonded pair means the pair which do not participate in formation of bond. Electron, valence electron which participate in bond called bonded pair, and remaining electron non-bonded but valence electron. So out of these 5 electrons, 3 are used and form bonded pair, and 2 are remaining. Suppose this is HCl. In HCl, chlorine become minus, this become positive because transferring of one electron from to here. And now, this is HCl, this is ammonia. When ammonia react with HCl, after the reaction, this type system is formed. So, this type system means these non-bonded pair from ammonia are provided to this. In this case, whole system is represented in this form, NH4 plus Cl minus. So this plus comes here. So these three are covalent bond, this bond is dating bond or coordinate bond, and this is the ionic bond. This is ammonium, this is chloride. So in ammonium chloride, ionic bond, coordinate bond, and three covalent bond are present. So today we have discussed different type bonds. Ionic bond are formed by transferring of electron from metal to non-metal. Covalent bond are formed by sharing of electron between equal number of electron between two elements. And coordinate bond is formed by completely donating of non-bonded pair from one molecule to another atom or molecule. Thank you. Namaskar. Stay safe.